Hello everyone, in this video session I am going to practically demonstrate a Java program to print right triangle star pattern. So this is a right triangle star pattern, guys, that we have to print with the help of the Java program. Let's explore more about this right triangle star pattern here in this notepad. As you can see, the first thing we need to find out from this right triangle star pattern is how many rows are available in this right triangle star pattern. So here, this is the first row, second row, third row, fourth row, fifth row. Total 5 rows are there. So here also in the Java program, we need to create a for loop meant for number of rows. Okay, this for loop is meant for number of rows. This for loop will iterate the number of rows times. So for int I is equal to 0, I less than 5, I plus plus. So this for loop will iterate how many times? The number of rows times. Total number of rows is 5. So this for loop also will iterate 5 times like that. This for loop is meant for the number of rows iteration. Done. Next thing that we need to understand from this star pattern is the first row only 1 star is there. The second row 2 stars are there. Third row 3 stars. Fourth row 4 stars. Fifth row 5 stars. Now we need to write an inner for loop which is meant for printing the stars based on the number of the row. Okay, if the number of the row is 3, only 3 stars should be printed. Such kind of inner for loop we need to create. For int j is equal to 0, this for loop is meant for printing the stars, guys. How many stars should be printed? The stars should be equal to the number of rows. I stands for rows. Okay, I is meant for rows. So here j is stars. Stars should be less than or equal to I. That means number of stars is equal to number of the row. Like that, we are writing this particular condition to print the number of stars according to the number of rows, number of the row. So number of stars to be printed should be equal to the number of the row. So for that we are writing this code, that's fine. Now inside this inner for loop, we'll write system.out. Instead of ln, I'll say normal print. And here we are meant to print a star, right? Let's print a star like this. Fine. So how many stars will be printed? Let's see that. Let's understand, okay? Walk through this code and see how many stars will be printed. For int I is equal to 0, here I is 0, guys. Then 0 less than 5. Yes, I less than 5. That is 0 less than 5. True. We'll go inside the for loop. So another for loop will come where j is equal to 0. Here j is 0 and 0 less than or equal to I. 0 less than or equal to what is I? I is also 0. So 0 less than or equal to 0. True or false? True. Go inside the inner for loop and we'll be printing this star. Star will be printed. Again, j will be incremented by 1. J will become 1. Is 1 less than or equal to 0? No, 1 is not less than or equal to 0. So we'll come out of this for loop. Only how many stars got printed? Because this is the first row, only 1 star got printed. While trying to print the second star, the condition became false, which is not possible, right? So only 1 star got printed. After printing a star here, after printing a star in the first row, we need to go to the new line. So we'll come out of the for loop and here we need to write a statement for going to the new line. System.out.println. ln stands for new line. Go to the new line. So after printing this star, we'll go to the new line. Done. So now again, I plus plus will happen here. So I is 1, 1 less than or equal to 5 is true. We'll go inside. Here j is equal to 0. Now again j is equal to 0. J is less than or equal to I. 0 is less than or equal to I. This is second row, guys. I is equal to 1 means second row. In second row, 0 less than or equal to I. True. We'll print a star. A star will be printed here in the second row. And j plus plus will happen after printing this star. J will become 1. 1 less than or equal to I. 1 less than or equal to 1. I is nothing but 1, right? So 1 less than or equal to 1. True again. Another star will be printed. Another star will be printed. So here 2 stars will be printed. The second row 2 stars got printed. When I again after this print ln. So we'll go to the new line like this. Then I plus plus. I will become 2. 2 less than 5. Again true. So here j less than or equal to 2. How many stars will be printed? 3 iterations it will go through. 0, 1, 2. right? So three stars will be printed in the third row. When I becomes 3, 4 stars will be printed. When I becomes 4, 5 stars will be printed. Like that, guys. You see, according to the number of the row, the number of stars will be printed. So this is how the logic is working. Till here, it is fine. Till here, it is fine, guys. But there is one more thing we need to understand. You see here, after every star, there is a space. Okay? In between these two stars also, there is a space. How to get this space? After the star, how to get the space? Here, after printing this star, we need to give a space like this. Star space. Save this and run the code. Now, when you run this code, total 5 rows, and according to the number of the row, the number of stars should be printed along with the space. And after every row, in order to go to the new row, we are writing this println statement. Hope you understood the entire logic now. Now let's run this code and see whether we are getting this right star triangle pattern getting printed in the output or not. We should see the right triangle star pattern. Run this. You see, right triangle star pattern is perfectly printed here. So hope, guys, you understood how to write a Java program to print right triangle star pattern. So that's it, guys. Thank you. Bye.